On September 22, 1986, Gordon Shumway crash-landed into the Tanner family's garage and our collective hearts. ALF was a cultural phenomenon in the 80s. The live-action show ran for 4 seasons with over 100 episodes and not one, but 2 animated series produced during its run. The show saw its untimely cancellation in 1990 and had a short TV land series and a made-for-TV film. But after that, just a few failed attempts at bringing the character back. Now, 35 years later, ALF has mostly been regulated to a punchline.
ALF Pogs. Remember ALF? He's back in pog form.
While we would never call the sitcom a masterpiece, it is still worth celebrating the history of everyone's favorite resident Melmac. I'm Robert Bacon of the 91 Donkey Lane podcast and the Geekscape Network, and this is the history of ALF. The story of ALF begins with puppeteer Paul Fusco. For fun, he used to annoy friends and family with this alien-looking puppet he created. Paul loved this puppet so much, he decided to audition for former Jim Henson manager Bernie Brillstein. He was able to win over the legendary producer with his currently unnamed alien puppet, and the two teamed up with former Muppet writer Tom Patchett to write the series pitch that they shopped to NBC. The pitch was, ALF, short for Alien Life Form, crash lands on Earth after his planet of Melmac was destroyed in a nuclear holocaust. On Earth, Willie Tanner and his wife sit in their garage using Willie's radio when ALF's spaceship crashes into their house. Quickly, the Tanners, Willie and Kate, and their children Lynn and Brian, all decide to keep ALF a secret after finding out that if the FBI found out about him, they would have to put ALF in a cage, do experiments on him, and ultimately dissect him. And that was overall the basic premise of the show. Unfortunately, even with the very real possibility of death, ALF is bad at keeping a low profile. At least half of the episodes involve people meeting ALF in some way. At one point, he even dates a blind woman, and in another, becomes a successful makeup salesperson. It's all over the phone, of course. The series was intended to be a generic family sitcom, but quickly became popular amongst children. This caused the showrunners to drop aspects of the character between the first and second season. One of the biggest changes was that ALF could no longer drink beer. This was a point of contention for creator Paul Fusco, who insisted that since Gordon Shumway was technically 265 years old, that it's fine for him to enjoy a brew every now and then. But to be fair, kids are stupid, and kids in the 80s were even more stupid. It was very common for them to mimic things that they saw on TV. One of the most well-known things about ALF was that Gordon, and really all Melmacians, eat cats as a source of food. While this continued through most of the series, it was toned down as the show became more popular amongst kids. Specifically, after one dumb child tried to microwave his family cat after seeing ALF attempt the same thing. The biggest controversy came from the two-part episode, Try to Remember. In this episode, ALF attempts to turn the Tanner's bathtub into a whirlpool with an electric mixer, and ends up electrocuting himself into having amnesia. Some kids saw this, and somehow thought it would be an awesome idea to recreate it. So, the showrunners decided to reshoot the whole scene, with ALF just slipping in the shower instead. Now, none of this stopped the showrunners from capitalizing on ALF's popularity with children, and they decided to make a spin-off series about their beer-guzzling, cat-eating puppet with an animated show that was launched in 1987. The cartoon showed Gordon's life before Melmac exploded, and also introduced his family, Bob, Flo, Curtis, and Aggie, as well as his dog Keep and his bird Harry. Now, the cartoon doesn't say, but this is a prequel, so it's only safe to assume that all of these characters were killed when Melmac exploded. So when you watch this show, remember all these characters. All of them, every single one of them, died. Nuclear Holocaust. The animated series was initially popular enough that a second spin-off was created in 1988 called ALF Tales, in which the characters from the animated series would recreate popular fairy tales. Both shows ended up being canceled after 2 extremely short seasons. You'd be shocked to find out how little information there is about these cartoons, but given that they only produced 26 episodes of each show at a time when most cartoon series, no matter how poor the quality, usually ran for at least 52 episode seasons. It's safe to assume there was not much faith in this show from the start. despite the failed animated shows, the original was still very popular and peaked in success during their second season. ALF began appearing on television outside of the show regularly and was already a pop culture icon. ALF was a semi-regular on Hollywood Squares, he hosted the 1989 Macy's Thanksgiving Day Parade, he guest-hosted on an episode of Talk Soup, he appeared on shows like Blossom, The Love Boat, Next Wave, and, in probably the strangest crossover, appeared in an episode of Matlock. I'm sure kids really loved that Matlock episode. ALF also starred in the 1987 TV special ALF Loves a Mystery, where he revealed NBC's Saturday morning lineup, because for some reason that was a thing in the 80s. Creating a TV special that is really just an hour-long commercial promoting your new television block, and for some reason, people tuned in to watch it. To be fair, we still do that now, but it's called Space Jam: A New Legacy. ALF wasn't just used for corporate greed, though. He was also used in several public service announcements, including one for the United States Department of the Interior. But his most well-known and probably strangest is his involvement in the drug prevention cartoon special, All Stars to the Rescue. Now, that cartoon alone needs its own video to completely unpack everything insane that's in that thing. So if you don't want to miss that one, make sure to click subscribe and click on that notification bell. The 80s were filled with giant cultural juggernauts that exploded in popularity only for them to fade away just as quickly. And unfortunately, ALF was one of them. The ratings tanked in the fourth season as NBC continued to shift the show to different time slots, hoping to recapture the audience. NBC did promise a fifth season to Paul Fusco's production company, but ultimately pulled that promise after the fourth season ended with the show dropping over 20 points in the Nielsen ratings. Unfortunately for Gordon Shumway, the last episode of season 4 ended with a cliffhanger ending, involving the FBI finally capturing him. With no closure, many ALF fans were worried about their favorite Melmacian. Was this the end? Was he captured by the FBI only to be experimented on and then ultimately split open? Well, those questions were finally answered in 1996 when ABC ran the made-for-TV movie Project ALF. Unfortunately, ALF had been out of the cultural zeitgeist for a while at this point, and no one really bothered to tune in. It had been 6 years since anyone had even thought about ALF, unless you were one of the 10 hardcore fans who read the Marvel-published ALF comic book that was released in 1994. While the steady decline of ALF's popularity might have been a blow to Paul Fusco and fans of the series, that probably wasn't the case for the actors and crew on the show. Filming ALF was a technical nightmare for everyone involved. Similar to The Muppet Show, the whole set was built on an elevated stage with room below for the puppeteers. But unlike The Muppet Show, the cast of humans was much larger than their one puppet counterpart, and it made filming extremely demanding. Just one 22-minute episode would take 20 to 25 hours of filming due to all the tech that they had to do. For comparison, in the 90s, it was considered excessive that a single episode of Friends took 6 hours to film. So it's easy to understand why most of the actors did not enjoy filming. The one who hated it the most was Max Wright, who played Willie Tanner, the dad. He openly despised playing the supporting role to an inanimate object, and hated that ALF got all the best lines. The experience was so bad for him that on the last night of the final episode, he left the set, grabbed his bags, and left without saying goodbye to any of the cast or crew. There have been multiple attempts to revive ALF since the 1996 made-for-TV movie. In 2002, ALF appeared in a series of commercials for the 1010-220 telephone service, as well as appearing on Jimmy Kimmel Live and the NBC 75th anniversary special. In 2004, TV Land gave ALF a new TV series called ALF's Hit Talk Show. The talk show, inspired by a classic ALF episode where he hosts The Tonight Show, involved ALF and Ed McMahon interviewing guests like Drew Carey, Tom Green, Linda Blair, and Tom Arnold, basically the who's who of the 90s. After 7 episodes, the show was canceled and is regarded as one of the worst talk shows in television history. Since then, ALF has made cameos in shows like The O'Reilly Factor, Mr. Robot, Young Sheldon, and a Funny or Die parody, Donald Trump's Art of the Deal, the movie. But thus far, any attempt to revive the character has not panned out. ALF creator Paul Fusco was pitching a film in 2012, and it was reported to be a CGI live-action movie, but almost a decade later, we have yet to get any more info about it, leaving most of us to assume that it's no longer in development. In 2018, Warner Brothers was reported to be working on an ALF reboot, but then later that same year, it was reported to be canceled. Most recently, in May 2020, Deadline stated that a reboot was being developed by HBO Max, but there are currently no details. So, what do you think? Is ALF a relic of the past that should be forgotten, or should we give him another shot? Gordon Shumway is constantly appearing on lists about science fiction and aliens, and was once even invited to the White House because ALF was Ronald Reagan's favorite show. So, obviously there's pros and cons to bringing him back. If you like this content, make sure to give us a like and subscribe. We release new videos every week filled with pop culture goodness. Thanks so much for watching.